What's up guys, today I'm going to show you how to download the Ubuntu OS, okay? So, basically we're going to dual boot, okay? So, your Windows won't get lost, okay? So, don't worry, it's with only dual boot, okay? So, I'm just going to recycle bin. First, I'm going to delete the Ubuntu from my computer. So, programs and features. Okay, went quite a while. Now Ubuntu, right click, and uninstall. Okay, so it's that easy to uninstall your Ubuntu. Okay, so yeah, let's uninstall it. No, basically I won't uninstall it because it is really quite a while to reinstall it again, so I was like, okay, so I just show the features, okay? What? No, I don't want to reinstall, okay? So, yeah. So, first, go to old.ubuntu.com and the URL here has been. Sure, okay. You might want to pause the video and copy the URL if you want. Okay, and then open another video and say Ruby download buffer that ASH. Okay, so here you can download the ISO software of the Ubuntu, and here you can download the Ruby application to use. Now, this is the application which we are going to use to download the Ubuntu. Okay. So I download both over here. Okay. Now once you start the Ruby application, it will ask for the permission. I'll click on yes. Okay, so I already installed Ubuntu, so it says that I have to uninstall Ubuntu before I install Ubuntu. So I am not going to uninstall it, okay? So, basically what I will do is I'll show you what it will be there, okay? So, it will look something like this, okay? So, you will have to, so you have to choose your drive over here. Okay, so once you started the Ubuntu installer, it would look like something like this. Okay, so you've got to choose the installation drive over here. Okay, and then you have to choose the language, and then you have to choose the installation. And then I think you might want to not change the username, okay? So if you want, you can, but I don't recommend it so much, okay? And then you have to choose the password, okay? And so basically password is for the pseudo security, okay? I'll show you how it works, okay? So first of all, don't click install before I say something, okay? First of all, be aware you are using Windows 10 or 8 because I'm using a Windows 7 machine, okay? So I don't know if this thing works in Windows 7 or Windows 8 or Windows 10, okay? So if you're using Windows 7, do it, okay? If you're not, then if you want to, you can, but have a backup at least, because I don't know if anything works in Windows 8 or 10. I don't know because I've never used, and I have used a Windows 10 machine, but I've never tried this on a Windows 10 or 8 machine. Okay, so just be aware, if you're using Windows 7, no worries, okay? So once you have done it, click Windows 7 install, then it will install Ubuntu for 2 or 3 minutes, okay? And then if there will be an option if you want to reboot now or you want to reboot manually later, okay? So first of all, when you will, okay, so first of all, close the applications after you have done these things, okay? And then click on the reboot now button, okay? And then the first time you have restarted your computer, it will boot into the Ubuntu installation, okay? So Ubuntu won't install in 2 or 3 minutes, okay? It would take quite a while once you have installed it, okay? So just be aware of that, okay? So don't worry, it would install, okay? So be aware if you're using Windows 8 or 10. And yeah, so once you click on the reboot now, it will restart your computer and boot into the Ubuntu operating system, okay? First there will be a black screen and there will be some words and letters working together. So just don't worry, okay? So it would automatically restart when it's done. So I'll see you in the next video. Bye.